Okay, so I look at this as two different things. It's really the technology that builds the cyber environment, and then there is the technology that secures the cyber environment. And obviously these are related, and you can't do one in isolation of the other, but it's easiest to think about it that way. So within the technology, one of the first things we look at is we have a very strong program in networks and communications. So in a cyber environment, you have many different types of devices. They could be mobile devices like cell phones, big servers in the cloud, all talking to each other. So we have a lot of work on how to build these networks in an optimized way, to optimize communications, to support the applications that people use, to make them resilient against failure or against potential misuse, and to recover them if there's failures. Okay, so that's one aspect of cyber environments. We have a big program on data analytics. So there's a new program within Penn State called Data Science. Data science encompasses everything from learning algorithms to see trends in data to analytics to try to pick out, you know, important pieces of information that people can use. And again, this is a big application of cyber environments because in the cloud, there's a great amount of data stored. There's great processing capabilities, and people can mine this data to find answers to questions that aren't apparent. What goes along with that is ensuring people's privacy. We have a very strong effort here on allowing data to be analyzed without compromising the privacy of people who have stored their data in the cloud, so to speak. We have a lot of work on high-performance computing. This goes all the way down to devices, you know, electronics, how to make chips that are faster, chips that are more efficient, all the way up to different processing paradigms, programming languages, hardware designs, computer architectures, things like that. And then finally, I would say we have work on power management. So as I said, for the cyber environments to be used, they have to be cost effective and they have to be environmental friendly. So again, we have people looking at everything from low power chips all the way on up to how do you allocate resources in data centers to keep the power consumption low. So that's sort of the optimized part of the cyber environment.